Matic, Mina Bird, Dunker, and Summer Bird.
In the meantime, my Matt Bird has been taken back to last division and taken immediately to the rail by Calvin Burrell. So the field moves into the first turn now. And it's Dunker who will be the leader today. Dunker leads. Mina's escape is second on the outside. Mr. Hunt sub third to a quarter is 23 and success second. Terrible Man is waiting just off the pace today. He's fourth on the outside. Summerbird rides the rails in fifth. Flying Private is sixth. Chocolate Candy is now seventh, and Brave Victory is eighth. And that's Love Double racing ninth. Three lengths back with Cold and Confident Calvin Burrell with Mind That Bird. They're in last position once again to a half mile that was pretty strong. 47 seconds left. So Mind That Bird about 9 lengths from a good pace up front. And that pace is being set by Dunkirk with 7 furlongs remaining here in the Belmont Stakes. Miner's Escape is pumping the pace for the outside. Terrible Man in good striking position. Now running in third. Down for the inside is Mr. Hot Stuff, racing fourth and Flying Private in between horses. Down for the inside is Summerbird. Alongside that one, Brave Victory is up, hold on for one. And then on the inside, Chocolate Candy. And second to last is Mind That Bird with 5 furlongs to go. He's 7 lengths from the lead as they enter the far turn. Love Gov is the tailor. They've run 3 quarters in 1:12 and 2. Around the far turn. Dunkirk still leading the way. Dunkirk by 3 quarters of a length. The Man gets a pull from the way. And Mind That Bird running like a shot. Here comes Mind That Bird with a strong loose for the lead on the far outside. He catapults him by horses. And now they're coming to the stretch. And it is Mind That Bird going to take the lead.
Across the backside, but he got a little rank with him at the 5 furlong pole and pulled him up.
Let's get down to the track to Peyton Bradar. Pulled him up close to the
right lead. Right now he's giving some comments and a shout out to the other bird. Calvin, tell me what happened.
Oh, that was so slow up front, you know. And, I mean, I had to let him go a little bit on the backside. He was kind of fighting a little bit, but I don't know, I made the lead at 15 poles, so I thought he's all free.
The horse is down the box. Hey, he's biting just a little bit. Is that different from his previous race?
Yeah, well, I'll get back to him up to the today, you know. It was unbelievable how through they went, you know. And we kind of grabbed a hook to the gate. I didn't want to fight him too much, but I let him, you know, creep up easy enough. I can say he runs great. He's not that hard, but he runs great.
Your thoughts at this point on the final leg of the trip and crown?
I'm happy today. I'm happy. Love Mom and Dad getting us. Love finally back home.
We'll get us out of the backside. Talk us through the race a little bit.
Well, I tell you, the colt broke like a rocket, and I was like, wow, how come he's been so far back? You know, he absolutely drug me around the racetrack. I had an armchair ride until I found some room. And when I found some room, he really just laid his body down. I tell you, this morning I left the house with a will to win this race. This race is about beauty, class, elegance.
Were you aware that Calvin was, his horse was getting a little rank with him and maybe he had to move up a little sooner than he would like?
No, I tell you what I realized that I was still on the armchair ride, still trapped with nowhere to go, and the horses in front of me weren't opening up. I could only hope at that point that when I did get a place to present this coat, out that way. We stuck it out. I'm so happy for Jim Ike. He's a family friend. We had dinner together in my house many years ago. It's just not too close. My brother Keith, he's an assistant for my brother for several years, so I'm happy for him.
The Louisiana boys, congratulations. Tim Ike's a rookie trainer. Now for a veteran trainer, Chip Woolley, Janine's with him.
Yeah, and I was watching Chip Woolley as he was watching the race of Mike Edberg. You were screaming, you were on your feet, and the next time I looked at you, you were sitting in your chair, dejected. What are you feeling right now?
Well, I'm awful disappointed. I think my horse probably is the best horse here. We just made a little early move there, come up a little empty, you know. They said Calvin said he was kind of fighting him a little bit down the backside, but you could tell when Calvin set him down, maybe a hair early, you know, but it's a judgment call out there, and I pat him on the back when I seen him.
Well, you must have been pretty happy when you saw him drop back to last. He wasn't fighting him then. He got the rail. It was a pretty moderate pace. You had to be fairly comfortable at that point.
When they flashed up the numbers, I thought we would win pretty much for sure. I thought when they went fast enough, 23 and 47 was fast enough to bring them back a little. I thought we were in good shape, but I could see down the backside Calvin was letting him drift up. And when you let this horse do that, he's gonna try to go, you know. And so he'd have been better off probably keeping him covered up down on the fence for a while. But you know, it's easy to say now. Calvin was out there trying to win the race, and we just got beat.
When you have a win, a second, and a third in the three Triple Crown races, your horse did a heck of a job. Where might we see him next, or have you even thought that far ahead?
We've thought some about it. We'll assess the horse and maybe go back to Churchill Monday, rest him a little bit, and come up with a plan and announce that in a few days, as long as he's 100% healthy.
We'll catch up with Calvin. Thanks, Chip.
As for the inquiry, let's show you what the stewards here at Belmont are looking at. Here at Belmont, after this message and a word from our ABC station.